You're young. We're strong. We want a future we can live with, not the one they want to hand us.
Yeah, that's it. We'll create our own future. Okay, y'all. I'll be back on at noon. And remember, you're young. You're strong. You can make this world better.
Perfecto. Absolutamente perfecto. Mulberry, oatmeal, rhubarb, sourdough muffins. Try them. Go on, try them.
What's in these again?
I found the mulberries growing in Prospect Park.
I got them last year when they still allowed people my age on the trails. I combined them with that double order of oatmeal Instacart accidentally delivered. I added the rhubarb from the garden for color and texture. So, what do you think? What do you think?
Definitely a new taste sensation. It's so, unexpected. Pure genius, Andrew. Pure genius.
Jared, what do you think?
They're different. In a really interesting way. Well, really, really interesting.
Eat up, eat up. Gotta feed the sourdough. I gotta collect the eggs from Mildred and Molly and milk Mimi. Goats don't like to be kept waiting. Then I have to feed the sourdough. And then you can tell me what you want for dinner. It's important to keep everything on a precise schedule.
Jared, you need to be more supportive of your father.
Mom, he's turned our whole house into a farm. This is crazy.
Say something nice sometimes. You know how unhappy he is. When the school said no one over 60 could go back to work, it broke his heart. He needs something fulfilling. And if that's Mimi, Mildred, and Molly, then so be it.
I mean, it was one thing when he started making bread, but now he's putting old sourpuss in every meal, every day.
He has nothing else. Sourdough, goat milk, fresh eggs, the garden, that's his life. Taking care of things, that's what a teacher does. That's what he's doing.
But Mom, please, not one more bite of sourdough.
Speaking of which, maybe you should put these in storage.
Long before Dad realizes where all his sourdough creations have gone.
I told him that as long as we have another working bathroom, the city won't allow a plumber to come in to repair it until the pandemic is completely finished. Anyway, a room full of baked goods is good insurance against a food shortage.
Mimi, get back here.
Dad, come back.
Can't go out to catch an escaped goat? I should just let her run wild through the neighborhood, eating up everyone's garden?
Oh, honey, your muffins were incredible. We just couldn't stop eating.
You didn't leave me one?
Sorry, it's totally my fault. I got carried away, I didn't think.
Next time, leave me at least one. Well, gotta feed the sourdough.
Whole sourpuss is like a great blob of a living thing. You feed Mimi, Molly, Mildred,
Puss. And my family, that's my job. Your mother's job is tracing the people who've been exposed to the people who've been exposed to the virus. You influence the internet, And me, I'm providing. Yes, I'm still the provider, just not like it was before.
Oh, honey, it wasn't fair. You didn't have any pre-existing conditions. They had no right.
Age is a pre-existing condition. They're afraid an old teacher will die in the middle of the school year. They're not wrong. The over 60s are dropping like flies. The over 70s have practically disappeared.
You'll outlive us all, Andrew.
Not if they have anything to do with it.
Dad, that's just a crazy conspiracy theory. There is no they.
Both your grandmothers were gone within months of each other.
Honey, that was the nursing homes. When the pandemic first hit, we should have taken them out. But by the time we realized what was happening, it was too late.
One day Mom was here, the next day she was gone. We never even had one conversation with them after they got sick.
Dad, Granny Sachs was 85. Your mom was 93. They were just old.
I'll never forgive myself. I thought we couldn't handle Mom's Alzheimer's. I don't know. I'll never forgive myself.
Okay, but that's when the pandemic first started. But what about Ann Cummings? She was still teaching gym at 72. She was healthier than the three of us put together.
That was a shocker. I asked to be her tracer, but they said I couldn't trace someone I knew personally. She was so careful and so healthy.
She was 72. She was old.
But she wasn't expendable. She was a person. She had a life. She was a teacher. No one knows how she got it. No one knows how she got sick.
But she was old.
And in your calculations, Jared, what about me? What is old?
You are, Dad. You're old. Admit it. That doesn't mean that I want you to get sick and die. I want you to egg the chickens and milk the goats. Or milk the chickens and egg the goats, or do whatever the hell you want to do as long as you want to do it.
We need you, honey. We all need you. Me, Jared, Mimi, Molly, Mildred, and even old Sourpuss. You are in the at-risk age group.
At risk for what? We haven't even talked to anyone who's had this thing since they lifted the shelter-in-place order for everyone except the over 60s. I can't even walk down my own street, or drive in the car, or even chase the goat when she gets loose. Why is that?
To protect you. Your family wants to protect you. Society wants to protect you. The government wants to protect you. We all want to protect the
protect us or hide us away. Take away our rights little by little. Make us useless to society so that society has an excuse to do
what?
You know to what. I'm not the fool you think I am. I know what you're up to.
What, Dad? What are we doing?
Jared, you're upsetting your father.
He's not upsetting me. I know what he's doing. I'm not the fool he thinks I am. I'm not so ancient that I can't log on to the trendiest internet influencer of the under 30s. I'm not an imbecile. I logged on last night and listened to my son.
It's just talk, Dad. We're not doing anything. We're just trying to figure out a future, a way out.
Jared, what is your father saying?
It's nothing, Mom. It's just conversation. It's chatter.
Chatter about how we, over 60s, are bringing down the entire healthcare system, how we over 60s are draining the economy. Well, the government won't let us work, so it's pretty damn difficult not to be a drain.
We're trying to figure a way out. Can't go on like this. When you were young, you hitchhiked through Europe, laid on beaches in Morocco. You realize there isn't one country in the world except Brazil that will allow us to visit. We're trapped. I mean, have you ever been to a socially distanced bar, had a socially distanced date?
No, Jared, I haven't been the fuck anywhere. I haven't been out of the house in 18 months. I can't go out because I have the pre-existing condition of age. I'd be overjoyed to go to a socially distanced bar.
Honey, you know why we can't.
Yeah, because
people my age, of people at risk, caught breaking this never-ending curfew, will be picked up, tested, told to have the virus, put into the hospital, and 2 days later they're dead.
You're crazy.
Jared, we've heard stories. People we've known all our lives are just disappearing. It's happening everywhere. Maybe it's a coincidence, maybe that's all it is, but maybe it's
some... no fucking coincidence. We're targets. I know what his generation's up to. They're trying to get rid of all of us.
I'm not trying to get rid of you, that's crazy. Sure, I say some stuff on my vlog, but I don't say to kill everyone over 60. Dad, your generation destroyed the economy, destroyed the planet. What little hope we had left was destroyed by this pandemic, but it's not you. I'm not trying to get rid of you.
Don't you think that what you say incites people? Don't you see the connection between what's happening, what you are saying?
Dad, those people caught the virus. They were old, they got sick, they died.
That may have been true at the beginning, but that's not what's happening now. Ann Cummings never had the virus. She never got sick. All she did was walk her own damn dog down her own damn street, and now she's dead.
She said on the phone, I'm gonna walk my own damn dog down my own damn street.
She broke the rules.
Maybe if you break the rules, you deserve to die.
Decade by decade. That's what your vlog says. Decade by decade. The only way to ensure your future is to eliminate the dead wood decade by decade.
But not you, Dad. Never you. Just don't go out. Mom and I will take care of all your needs. Just don't go out.
Jared, what are you saying?
It's nothing.
What are you a part of?
It's nothing you have to worry about. I'll always protect the both of you. You just need to obey the rules and stay inside. I can't protect you outside of the house.
But, Jared, you knew about our friends? You knew about Anne? And Stephanie? Larry and Georgette? Aunt Marge, you knew about them all and now they're all dead? You knew their habits? Jared, tell me this isn't you. Please, tell me this isn't you.
You always taught me needs must. Sometimes needs must. We're fixing a problem that needs to be fixed.
Now I understand why some people contract the virus and die without ever being infected by anyone else. Without ever infecting anyone or being infected by another person. There have been so many people I could never get a trace on. Now I understand.
This isn't how we raised you.
Jared, do you really believe in what you're doing?
Yes, Mom, it's the only way.
Well, then as long as we've gone this far in disappointing your father, why don't we go all the way and show him what's in the bathroom?
Are you sure?
Yes, absolutely.
What is this? What is all this?
Your creations, Dad. It was just too much sourdough. We had to do something.
My pretzels? You didn't even eat my pretzels? Even my pretzels?
Your pretzels were delicious. Jared, come and can you get down the pretzels for your father? They're on the top shelf. Do you see them? Step up on the sink so you can reach them. That's it. There.
Hey! Mom? Mom, what did you do?
Mom?
Joke's over, open the door!
What have you done?
We need time to think. He'll be fine. It's a working bathroom with water and everything. And there's plenty of food. He'll be fine.
And my pastries?
Open the door.
Jared will learn to love your delicious sourdough.
Jump's over.
Well, actually, some of them are quite good, especially the savories.
You have no right.
What do you want to do now?
I have purpose. People want to hear me.
Maybe we should open a bottle of wine.
Open the door! Dad!
What about his fan base?
I'll take it over in Jared's name. I'll bring my 65 years of wisdom and teaching to his generation. I'll keep his style, but change his message. Oh, this is going to be very exciting.
You always were a skilled teacher. Teacher of the year, 7 years running.
I'm exactly what these young people need. Oh, this is something I can sink my teeth into. Although it may be a bit time-consuming and influencing an entire future generation.
Don't worry, I'll take care of Mimi, Mildred, and Molly. What about old Sourpuss?
Toss it. If there's one thing the world doesn't need more of right now, it's more sourdough.
Oh, honey. Look at the time. It's almost noon. Are you ready?
Absolutely. I couldn't be better prepared. This is the Jared J. Show, and I'm here at Jared's request to talk to you about saving our future. We're here. We're strong. We can make our future better together. Let's get right into it, shall we?
I can see and hear you. Do other people know about this Zoom thing?
Yes, Dad, one or two.
Why are you wearing a mask?
The virus.
You're alone in your apartment.
I'm expecting a delivery.
Oh, then you should wear your hazmat suit.
That's what they're delivering.
I'm surprised you ever left the womb.
Why do you have a big bandage on your head?
I wiped out this morning in Malibu.
You're still surfing?
I had a good long ride until I smashed into a pier.
Were you wearing your mask?
No, but I have one in the car.
What were you doing at the beach? It's dangerous.
It's actually not. Sea breezes keeps the virus from sticking. I wish I'd social distance that pier though.
Dad, you're not 20 anymore. You're not even 50.
I'm still the same. I just heal slower. I also broke some ribs. Ow. What do you do for fun on the weekends?
I fill out your insurance forms.
That's one of my big regrets about divorcing your mother. She used to do all that paperwork.
One of your big regrets. What's another?
Not getting custody of you.
Oh.
I could have taught you how to surf.
Okay, stop. You're ruining it.
Sorry.
So why'd you want to see me, Daddy? Your email said it was important.
I'm changing my life.
To what?
I had an epiphany. As they were giving me CPR, I realized it's September. The summer is over.
You don't need paramedics to realize that. You can do that with a calendar.
I meant September in the bigger sense.
Oh, what bigger sense is there?
Another summer is over, and how many more do I have?
Are you kidding? You're still young.
So, I'm quitting my job and surfing year-round.
What? You can't do that. You're old.
I'm gonna follow the waves around the world and have an endless summer.
Okay, that's it. No more Beach Boy records.
Hey, don't knock the Beach Boys, Wendy. You were named after a Beach Boys song.
Yes, and thank you so much for not naming me Little Deuce Coop.
You can thank your mother. I'm kidding.
Dad, you can't do this. It's crazy.
I should have done it years ago. I'm tired of working for the man.
The man? I hate to tell you, it's not just the summer. The 60s and 70s are over too.
In the words of the great Brian Wilson, catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world.
Even Brian Wilson, who is certifiably crazy, would tell you don't do this.
First up, Uluwatu in Bali. It'll be so nice not to surf in Malibu and have Barbara Streisand chase me off her beach.
Dad, you've been at Time Warner for 25 years. You're not furloughed. They let you work from home. You're one of six people in America who still has health benefits.
I'm on a quest, Wendy, to find that perfect wave, to hit that sweet spot and ride it for miles and miles and feel that I am at one with the universe. Then have a real Coke, even though I have diabetes.
You're serious about this?
I gave notice yesterday.
Wow! Worst unemployment since the Great Depression, and you're giving up a good career to go and search for Surf City?
Hey, two girls for every guy.
Okay, we're done here.
No. I'm kidding. That's just part of the song. What I'm really searching for is me. The me I used to be before your dear mother sucked the life force right out of me.
Well, Dad, if you've quit your job and this is what you want to do, good luck. Tell me where you are so I can send you ace bandages.
Thank you. Oh, wow.
What?
Cowabunga.
What does that even mean?
Like Quibi and TikTok mean something?
Okay. So cowabunga, explain.
I just had another epiphany.
Great, I'll call 911.
Why don't you come with me?
What?
Yeah, it'll be boss.
No!
We've never had the chance to spend any real time together since the divorce. It'll be a great daddy-daughter bonding experience.
Daddy-daughter bonding is us going to a Broadway musical, not the emergency room in Bali.
Broadway is closed.
You can still see Hamilton on Disney Plus.
Are you happy?
What?
In your life, are you happy?
I'm not going there.
You're dressed in a suit. It's Sunday.
I have a meeting later.
Oh, there's a dress code for Zoom? I'm not wearing any pants.
I'm turning off your camera.
You love your job?
I'm a sales rep from Verizon. How could I possibly love my job?
And why do you do it?
Because it pays well, and it pays well.
Summers go by really fast.
I'm not quitting my job. I get unlimited data.
Is there a boy in your life?
You know there's not.
Yes, that's why I asked it.
I'm not going to meet him with my father as my wingman.
Ah, you never know. I'll be hanging out with a lot of really cute athletic surfer boys.
Who are also bums that go around the world with no future.
Yeah, but they have great pecs.
I am also going to mute you.
You're a grown-up woman. You have sex.
If I had one wish in the whole world, you think it would be for a vaccine? No, it would be to get into that DeLorean and go back in time 3 minutes.
The point is, you need some adventure in your life. Everybody does.
Dad, I'm not like you.
Yes, but Isn't there a part of you? Even a small part that wants to be?
I don't surf. And when I'm your age, I want the use of my knees.
The part about wanting to be free. Summer is vacation. The rest of the year is all...
Of course I love summer. I only got to see it from a window this year, but it does end.
It's always summer somewhere.
Like I said, I don't surf.
But you write.
What?
You write stories.
How do you know that?
You've posted fan fiction. There were a couple of days I was in traction that I read it all.
Oh, okay. So yes, I do.
You're very good.
You're just saying that because you want me to push you around in a wheelchair when you wipe out in South Africa.
No, because you have a real talent for it.
You seriously think so?
Yes, I do. With all my heart.
Cowabunga.
Does it give you pleasure?
God, yes.
T-shirts, cutoffs, and a pair of thongs. We've been having fun. How? All summer long.
You're not allowed to have fun in a pandemic.
Yes, you are. Wendy, you still have lots of summers. So what's one or two? Come with me. Picture it. Sitting on the beach in your hazmat suit. If you're going to write, don't you need stuff to write about?
Like seeing the world.
When was the last time you left your apartment?
25 weeks ago.
Jesus! And I have to convince you to go to Bali?
Oh my God, I can't believe I'm even considering this.
Trust me, baby, better now than when you're my age.
I've binge-watched every series, including The Nanny.
You'll never regret it.
Okay. I'm an idiot.
Yes! And I love you for it. Surf's up.
Wendy and Peter off to the islands. Hey, it's kind of like Peter Pan.
That's who I was named for. And I'll let you in on a little secret. That's the Wendy you were named for, too.
So now the neighbor is involved.
He just set up the camera. He doesn't know.
But he's involved, and you don't know if
there was nothing else I could do. We were supposed to be together, but then you had to.
Please don't start that again. My interview was very important, crucial to me anyway.
And the second interview, how many crucials can you fit into one day? And this day of all days, you were cutting it close enough with the one you knew it had to happen tonight. So now I'm here by myself and you're...
Phew. I know. So this'll have to do, assuming we do it at all.
Assuming? What are you talking about? We planned this all year.
I know. It's just, now the time has come and I feel...
Now you're raising doubts. Now that it's time, exactly. After almost ruining everything with your damn interview. Tonight makes it 1 year. The plan was to meet here, then we'd go back together. Now we have to do it remotely, but we have to do it.
I don't know. It feels so...
Okay, enough with your feelings. You got your interview, didn't you? I come here to get you to bring you back and you're gone. A second interview. So here we are. Me here, you there, and her.
Where?
You know where.
And the neighbor filming.
The camera is motion activated. Joe won't be there. Besides, he's a good man. See no evil, speak no
evil. I don't know about that.
Enough. Put out your light, light your candle. It's been a year of tears, my tears. And now you must do your part. We must do our part.
Onevas getam te wanak danevu.
You must.
I never thought we
You must.
Onevas ketam te wan ark tanevu.
Terema soremi kisi janda.
Terema suremi kisi janda.
O nevas ketam tewan ark tanevu.
Tewan ark tanevu.
Can you hear me? Lori?
Is this happening? This can't be happening.
Lori. Oh my God, Lori.
It can't be. No. It can't be.
It must be.
Phil?
Yes. Oh my God. Yes, my darling. It's me.
Phil?
Yes. Oh my God. Yes.
This can't be happening.
Jen?
Yes. Yes, my darling, it's Jen. Oh, yes, it's our Jen. Oh, my God.
I can't. Talking, it's so hard. It's been so unnecessary.
Stop it. Just stop it.
She's having a hard time, dear. Believing. It hasn't been easy on her since you've been gone. Coming to terms, dealing with death at her age. And of course this, your resurrection. But you know me, darling, once I set my mind.
Our mind. Once we set our mind.
Yes, of course, our mind. Once we set our mind to it. Our research, the ritual. The tears, my tears, the incantation, our determination.
Our faith.
Yes. Yes, our faith.
Your sin. You can't think this isn't sinful. This? Even if your intentions were pure, loving, whatever, this act, it blasphemes.
We'll have to show her, darling. Leave that place. Join me at our home. Meet us there.
No, Phil, you must meet me here.
But the plan, our plan was for you to come back to us.
Yes, but that was before I came to know the afterlife. Sweet hereafter.
I don't understand.
She wants us to die.
No. No, of course not.
I want you to join me.
No, wait. We want you to join us. We want you with us, dear, among the living. That was the plan, our plan.
But you haven't seen what I have. You haven't felt what I have. I've lived what you're offering, Phil. Believe me, I know what you're offering. I am offering so much more.
You see, is she not crazy?
Lori, I think you must be confused. I mean,
after all that I have seen, felt, known, after all I have come to know, I am not confused, Phil. I am enlightened. I have answers to questions that every living soul wished they knew. Questions about themselves, questions about everyone else, questions about everything. I have answers, Phil. I now have answers, and I want you to have answers too.
Do you have answers to why we don't have answers? We, the living?
Oh, yes. I have answers to even that question and so much more. Answers to questions about war, disease, poverty, and the hardest question of all, why? You can't reach this understanding when alive, but oh, in the afterlife.
Yes, Lori, but you can't be serious. This miracle, our miracle, it was meant for you to join us. I mean, Jen has her whole life ahead of her, and so do I, and so do you.
How much more do you want, Phil? Life, I mean, this life that you're living, how much more? Several score more years, would that be enough? Several score more after that, and after that, how many? Would you ever have enough? If you want eternity, I can bring you there. Jen's thought about the afterlife, haven't you, Jen? Dreamed about it.
I have not.
Silly childish dreams. Remember, Jen, I have answers. I know your dreams. Would you be thinner? Would you be prettier, smarter? You've wondered, will those who suffer in this life be happier in the next? Remember, Jen, I know.
I don't care about your answers. You're dead. You're supposed to be dead.
Yes, and you're supposed to be happy. These are supposed to be your good old days.
Hey, Lori, no, no, no. No quarreling, no anger. Nothing but joy. It's our reunion. And we don't have much time, Lori. You know this.
Yes, yes, of course I do. But what can I do to convince you? You are so limited, so bound up with your notions of what? Making amends? Making up for... I know your failings. I knew them when alive, and I know them even better now.
Don't listen to her. Don't listen, Dad.
You don't need to worry about making up for your failings, Phil. You don't enter the afterlife by fulfilling a quota of good works. Everyone enters the afterlife. And don't think my answers don't reflect poorly upon me, Jen. They do. Oh, they do. So many of them do. Like my jealousy of your youth.
Please, 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 no confessions. I don't want to hear them. Not now.
My jealousy of your blossoming womanhood. Well, I...
Lori, don't do this, please.
I didn't realize it at the time. While living it, I had no idea of the jealousy, but now...
Yeah, I cried when you died, but it's too late. It's too late to undo.
Okay, stop it. Just stop it. It's not supposed to be like this. After all that we've done, after all that we've dared, a miracle, our miracle, a wonder beyond belief, beyond mortality, beyond... I just don't understand. How can you not want to live the life that was stolen from us?
No, I don't want to live forever. I just want to live better. I just started making plans. Whoa, wait, what? The candle. Dad, do you have matches? Dad? Wait. Dad?
Bill?
Dad?
Bill? Oh no. Oh no.
Oh my God, no. What have you done? What have you done?
I've done nothing. He took too long. We took too long. Phil, you can't leave me. You can't leave me here. You. Oh, you know the ritual. Yes, yes, of course you do. You know how to send me back. You know how to send us there to join your father. We can chant the invocation together, you and me.
No, oh no, and I don't know the ritual. I don't want to know it.
But you must. How can we?
There is no we. Not now, anyway. I can't do what you're asking.
Why not, Jen? Why? Out of spite? Resentment over past?
Resentment? No, it's just, I tried to tell him, but he wouldn't listen. This miracle, his miracle, your miracle. I knew it was a violation to bring you back, a violation of nature.
Violation
I tried to tell him, but he wouldn't listen. And so I went along anyway. And now this, your miracle, has turned into a curse.
Jen.
Look what happened. He's gone. I've lost him. You want me to sink deeper into this madness? No, I will not do it.
But we were so close. So close to eternity, the three of us, we still are, if
I'm
only-
I'm sorry, but for me, death is the end. Even if it wasn't for you, for me, death is the end. And before that, there's living.
But you have no idea what you're refusing. I mean, how could you? I'm trying to give-
I've got life, my life. I'm going to live it. I'm so sorry.
Jen.